Welcome to Leo's Workshop.
Well, this video is all about the process that I went through to make this family plaque. This is made out of cherry, and there's several steps that I had to go through. I make my things from rough sawn, or not what you would buy at Home Depot or Lowe's. These would come from a lumber mill, and it's just rough sawn wood. So I went through all of the steps to prepare the wood, glue up the panels. I made three of these plaques. One of them I sold, and I want to show you the steps that it took to go through this whole process to make these from start to finish, including a little bit of the design that I went through. This was photocopied from the script that was on a piece of paper, and I had to do a lot of text editing and internet research to find fonts and put this all together, and it was a bit of work to do the design work. This video is more about the process of making it than it is about the design work, although I'll post a couple of small segments of the design. But okay, so let's go through the process and see what it was.
I started with a piece of paper that needed to be photocopied. Then I brought it into my design software and created a design for it. After the design was created, then I can go create a preview, which is what's showing here. I start all my work with rough sawn wood and just rough cut the pieces to size, just the general size to get started with. Once I have all my project pieces cut to a rough size, I can start to go through the process of doing the flattening and straightening on my planer and jointer and sander, which is what's following. After all the planing and jointing and face jointing and sanding and cutting the project pieces to more dimensioned sizes, they actually start looking pretty good. You can see the grain on them. I'll sort out the pieces for the grain orientation, keeping the sapwood to the outsides of the project. Once I get that all oriented the way that I want it to be, then I can get into the gluing process. And I glue up using a series of clamps and try to get the clamping pressure even across the panel. It only takes about an hour to dry once I get the panels glued up and dried. Before the glue dries really hard, I'll take them out of the clamps and I'll scrape the glue off while it's still kind of in a rubbery state. You'll see that at the end of the glue-ups in the following videos. Thank you. some really nice panels right there.
Really important thing is to make sure that this is flat. I don't want any dust or particles on it. So I just got done sanding it and made it flat. I don't know if anybody really knows what I'm talking about, but when I sand it, I look to try to remove the shinies and leave the dulls. To me, that means that I've removed all of the high points, and the shiny would be the shellac that's in low points. And once I've sanded away the shinies, what I call the low points where you can see the shine on the shellac, when the shinies are gone, then I'm pretty sure that I've got all the peaks and valleys all flattened out. And when you're sanding shellac, you get little buildups and deposits left on the finish. I don't want anything like that. When I put the paint mask on, it's going to leave a little bump behind the paint mask and something for the paint to bleed into. So I take a single-edged razor blade and I just scrape off. I can feel sometimes a little bit. I can't see it, but I can feel it. And I just scrape and scrape away. And it's nice and flat now. I don't want any dust on it. I've used a tack rag. And I'm ready to put the paint mask on. This is about 22, 23 inches wide. And the paint mask roll is about 24 inches wide, so I'll just come and lay this down. What I'll do is I'll put the panel on top of the paper, and if I overlap a little bit bigger, that's perfectly fine. And then I'll draw a line and I'll just cut the paint mask just a tad bigger than I need. A little bit bigger doesn't really matter. I can trim it on the panel if I really want to. And then getting it on the panel is another trick in itself. So let's give that a shot. And that's going to go on there, and it's going to be nice and flat with no wrinkles. No wrinkles. That's the key. And I want to get it on straight. So, see, that's going to fit on there. A little bit of an overlap on the sides. And keeping dust and dirt away. And let's get started. So, the way that I do it is I kind of like roll it on. And I'll open up the end, because that's not always so easy. And I'll get the end exposed first. You don't want to stretch it as much as you can possibly help it. So I've got a little fold going on here, and that's where I'm gonna get started with. So I want that fold down. I want to make sure that this is going to go on straight. So I get it lined up down here, and I'll just use my thumb at the top just to press it down, and then get that first bead going there. So with my hand, I'll smooth out. You're always going to get some kind of a wrinkle or something, but now I'm pretty sure it's going to go on straight. So just a little by little, I will keep spreading this out. I don't want to go fast. Fast just doesn't pay. Because if you try to do it fast, you're going to have a wrinkle. If you have a wrinkle, there's just no way to fix it. There's all kinds of workarounds, but there's no good way to fix it. So I know that my surface is nice and smooth and clean. So if I keep doing this and I'm just patient about it, little by little, this whole panel will go on as straight as I need it to be. I'm off a little bit, I can tell already. Right over here I'm seeing wood. The panel is actually a little bit bigger than the project, so I'm not worried. And I'm just going to continue this all the way to the end. You can't correct it. Right here at this point, it's just going to lay wherever it's going to lay. It's not a single bubble in there. It's flat. Not going to get any better than that. And then what I'm going to do is use my utility knife and trim that. Okay, I went into my programming software, which is Vectric Aspire, and I looked at the model to see where I can put holes, and this is kind of the shape. It's like not exact, but that's kind of the shape of the pattern that I'm going to cut out. And I could measure 1 inch down and 1 inch over, and I can put a hole right there to mount a just a drywall screw is what I do, and I screw it right down to the spoil board. And so 4 holes in each corner. I marked out the 4 holes, so I just drill. Approximate location is fine. There's nothing exact about putting these screw holes in. So there's my 4 screw holes, and then I'm going to get ready to mount it up on the machine gun. Thank you.
After all the text engraving is completed, with the paint mask still on the panels, then I could start to go and paint them. And I just paint the whole thing all the way around with the black paint. I have to spray the paint from different angles to make sure it gets down inside of the text, and I completely cover it. I'll give it about 3 coats of paint until I'm sure that it's got a really good coverage on it. After that, I will meticulously peel off all the paint mask, and that's quite an effort, but you end up with some beautiful painted panels, V-grooved text. Gorgeous.